There's been something on my mind lately, and this will contain spoilers for ReZero. I'm sure many of you really got into ReZero due to the really interesting mechanics which it introduced, namely the nature of return by death, this idea of the main character dying, going back in time, and then doing different actions to save the people he loves. In fact, this is such a rare mechanic, I can't even really think of any identical series which uses the same return by death mechanic. I'm thinking maybe Higurashi, but that doesn't really count. I guess maybe the only sort of equivalent is a visual novel called Raging Loop, which literally has the main character with the ability of return by death, similar to Subaru. Now, the reason why I'm really bringing this up is because lately I've noticed a change in how Return by Death is used, and I'm sure many of you have also noticed this. In Arc 1, when Subaru died, he had around half a day to change the events which would have happened at the loot house. In Arc 2, Subaru had around a few days, 3-4 days, to survive being killed by Rem, or of course being cursed by the dog. In Arc 3 and Arc 4, again, Subaru had several days to turn it around. Remember, in Arc 3, he had to sort of get information to get Anastasia on his side, he had to rally the troops, he had to go to Flugel's Tree, he had to battle the White Whale, he had to then beat the Sin Archbishop of Sloth. You know, so he had a lot to do. In Arc 4, it was similar. He had to do a lot to get Garfiel on his side, you know, do the trials. You get the point. However, since the time skip, something has happened. Return by Death, it feels like it's changed in some way. That the periods of Subaru's checkpoints are getting a lot shorter. So what happens is Subaru will die, and then he only has a short amount of time to change what he does and avoid this danger. And we do see this in Arc 5, where Subaru dies to Sirius, the Sin Archbishop of Wrath. As you can remember, he literally returns by death and he only has a few minutes, 10-15 minutes or even less to avoid death, and it's such a short amount of time. And this actually happens again in Arc 6, because if you'll remember, Subaru gets headshotted by Shula, who 360 no-scopes him, and then he immediately returns by death in the middle of a flower field, and it's just like, whoa, what's going on here? The next major death loop was of course the Pleiades Watchtower. I am skipping over the tunnel death, but the next major one, of course, is the Pleiades Watchtower, where, again, Subaru had a really short amount of time to assemble his forces and then repel the four obstacles that they were facing. So Shola, the Witch Beasts, Reed Astria, and, of course, Liebatting Kaitos. So, again, he had a very short amount of time. In fact, in his last attempt, by the time he woke up, Emilia's name was already eaten when he arrived to her location. So again, it shows another time where his return by death point was extremely short. We then see this again in Arc 7, where Subaru gets choked out by Rem. He wakes up, he runs into a forest, he gets absolutely destroyed, and he immediately returns by death to just when he wakes up. The next loop was the Valakian encampment, which was actually a longer period of time when he did loop back. However, after that we had the Gwaral loop, where Todd killed Subaru like 5 times in 5 minutes. Again, Subaru had such a short return by death timer. And then afterwards we had the Obart scene, where Obart killed everyone except for Abel. And again, Subaru returned by death right at the start of his conversation. Now, the reason why I'm bringing this up is because I find this weird. I feel like something has happened since the time skip. I feel like the nature of Return by Death is evolving or changing, or something has happened to it. And this may seem like I'm paranoid, but in Chapter 42 of Arc 7, you can see this screenshot on screen of what Subaru says. And Subaru even notes how weird it is that his time in Gwaral was so short, And the same thing happened when he was with Obart, and he even suggests that maybe the authority is compromised. Now, do keep in mind, he does mention the Guiral case in this situation, so this is before Obart shrunk him down. Now, the fact that Tape is drawing attention to this, maybe it does indicate that something is happening to Return by Death. I mean, I do know that witch factors do eventually take over a person's body, but this is pretty weird if, you know, like, why is this being mentioned? And I thought I'd just make a video talking about it. And again, this is sort of like more of a discussion rather than me having the answers. I just want to know, what do you think? Do you feel like the witch factor is sort of changing? Or is maybe Subaru gaining witch factors changing his Return by Death checkpoints? Do you feel like there's something happening that we just don't know? Or do you feel like, let me know what you think, because I'm genuinely confused. This is obviously something that Tape is hinting at. Now, do keep in mind, I'm not including the death loop, because again, I have a video on that. I do believe that's actually Al's territory with the whole death loop on Yorna's castle. But it's obvious that Return by Death is changed in some way. It does feel compromised, and I want to know what you guys think about that. By the way, I know there's going to be one person that goes, actually, Jake, if you've seen Greed If and Wrath If, Subaru can die millions of times and that won't affect Return by Death. Yes, I know that. I'm not saying that Return by Death can have a limit or anything like that. I'm saying that the checkpoint system is, of course, changing. It feels a lot shorter. And again, of course, it's speculated that Satella is the one who controls the checkpoints, considering she's the one who gave him the power of Return by Death. And of course, in the death loop scene, when Subaru died and he didn't really return by death, Satella, of course, wondered where he was. So again, the death loop doesn't seem to be sort of linked to Return by Death, and it seems that Satella is, of course, the person setting the checkpoints. So why are the checkpoints now a lot more closer apart? Is Satella just griefing Subaru? She's appearing a lot more lately as well. She appeared in Arc 6, and then she just randomly appeared in Arc 7, which, by the way, is such a weird question. Why did Satella appear at the end of Arc 6, send Subaru to Valakia, and just not appear again? And now she appears again, of course, in Arc 7. So again, it's extremely weird. I feel like there's something up, and I feel like we're all missing what's going on. And I just want to know if anyone here has a sort of idea of what's going on. I've been rambling for quite a lot of time, but hopefully you guys understand the sort of point I'm putting across. And let me know what you think about it, and I'll see you guys next time.